إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Alhamdulillah, we praise Allah and we seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Wherever Allah guides, there is none that can lead him astray, and whoever is led astray, then there is no guide for him. I bear witness that no God has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He is alone and has no partners, and I bear witness that Muhammad is His slave and His messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah as He ought to be feared, and don't die except as Muslims. O humanity, fear your Lord who has created you from a single soul and created from it its mate and scattered from them too many men and women. And fear Allah for whom you demand your mutual rights and don't cut off relations with the wombs that bore you. Indeed, Allah is a raqib over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct, in order that He may accept from you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His messenger achieves the greatest achievement. Amma ba'du, certainly the most truthful speech is the book of Allah. And the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in this deen. And every newly invented matter in this deen is a bid'ah. And every bid'ah is a strang, and every strang is in the fire. We continue where we left off with the explanation or the belief of Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah, as he says, As-sunnatu ashara. فَمَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ فَقَدِ اسْتَكْمَلَ السُنَّةِ وَمَنْ تَرَكَ مِنْهَا شَيْئًا فَقَدْ تَرَكَ السُنَّةِ إِثْبَاتُ الْقَدَرِ وَتَقْدِيمُ أَبِي بَكْرٍ وَعُمَرٍ وَالْحَوْضِ وَالشَّفَاعَةِ وَالْمِيزَانِ وَالصِّرَاطِ وَالْإِيمَانُ قَوْلٌ وَعَمَلٌ وَالْقُرْآنُ كَلَامُ اللَّهِ وَعَذَابُ الْقَبْرِ والبعث يوم القيامة ولا تقطعوا بالشهادة على مسلم. سفيان بن عيينة رحمه الله, he said, the sunnah are 10. Whoever has them, then he has completed the sunnah. And whoever leaves off any of it has left off the sunnah. To establish the qadr or the divine decree. To give precedence to Abu Bakr and Umar. Belief in the hawd of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Belief in the intercession. Belief in the scales. Belief in the bridge over the fire. Belief that faith is a statement and an action. Belief that the Quran is the speech of Allah. Belief in the punishment of the grave. Belief in resurrection on the day of resurrection. And not to bear decisive witness against a Muslim. Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah, he establishes from the belief of the Muslim is ithbatul qadr, or belief in the divine decree. We have quoted many ayat and hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we'll take a look at a few more inshallah, as Allah ta'ala, he says, وَكَانَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ قَدْرًا مَقْدُورًا. And the command of Allah is a destiny decreed, or a decree determined. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed everything that will take place. And we also see this in the hadith of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu anhu qal sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqulu katab Allahu maqadir al-khalaiq قبل أن يخلق السماوات والأرض بخمسين ألف سنة أخرجه مسلم. عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما he said that I heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم say that Allah had written the decree of all of creation before the creation of the heavens and the earth by 50,000 years collected by Imam Muslim. وعن عبادة ابن الصامت رضي الله عنه قال لابنه يا بني إنك لن تجد طعم حقيقة الإيمان حتى تعلم أن ما أصابك لم يكن ليخطئك وأن ما أخطأك لم يكن ليصيبك سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن أول ما خلق الله القلم فقال له اكتب قال ماذا قال ربي وماذا اكتب قال اكتب مقادير كل شيء حتى تقوم الساعة قال يا بني إني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من مات على غير هذا فليس مني أخرجه أبو داود والترمذي وصححه الألباني Ubad ibn Samir radiallahu anhu, he said to his son, meaning at the time of his death, O my son, you will never taste the true sweetness of iman, of faith, until you know that what has happened to you would not pass you by, and that what has passed you by would not happen to you. I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, the first thing that Allah created was the pen. And he said to it, write. And it said, O my Lord, what shall I write? And he said, write all of the decree, or write everything that would take place up until the last hour is established. O my son, indeed I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, whoever dies on other than this, then he is not from amongst me. This is collected authentically by Abu Dawood and At-Tirmidhi. Here we see in these ayat and hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of which has been established in the aqid of Sufyan ibn Uyayna, the belief in the divine decree. And the believer, when he believes in that which Allah has decreed, then you find that he's not often sad or grieved, because he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already decreed what will take place. So this is an encouragement for the believers to work hard, to strive for the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not to feel regretful or saddened over what has taken place or what is taking place, because it's all been decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the belief. Teach it to your children, as we saw the Sahaba, or the Sahabi Ubad ibn Samir radiallahu anhu teaching it to his son at the time of his death, because the importance of it. This is one of the articles of Iman, belief in the Qadr, or the divine decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah, he said, وَتَقْدِيمُ أَبِي بَكْرٍ وَعُمَرٍ, and to give precedence to Abu Bakr and Umar. And we see this in the hadith of Abdullah, we see this in the hadith of عمر بن العاص رضي الله عنه أنه بعثه النبي أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعثه على جيش ذات السلاسل فأتيته فقلت أي الناس أحب إليك قال عائشة قلت من الرجال قال أبوها قلت ثم من قال ثم عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه فعد رجالا متفق عليه. عمر بن العاص رضي الله عنه, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent me in charge of an army to Dhatus Salasil. So I went to him and I said, who is the most beloved people to you? meaning to you, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Aisha, I said, from amongst the men, he said, her father, meaning Abu Bakr and As-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. I said, then who? He said, Umar ibn al-Khattabi radiyallahu anhu. And then he mentioned other men. This is collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. وعن عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنه قال كنا نخير بين الناس في زمن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فكنا نخير أبا بكر ثم عمر بن الخطاب ثم عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنهم أخرجه الإمام البخاري. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he said that we used to decide during the time of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who was the best of the people. So we chose Abu Bakr, then Umar, then Uthman radiallahu anhum. And this is collected by Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. Wa an Aishata radiallahu anha annaha su'ilat من كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مستخلفا لو استخلف قال أبو بكر فقيل لها ثم من بعد أبي بكر قالت عمر فقيل لها ثم من بعد عمر فقالت عبيدة أبو عبيدة ابن الجراح قالت أبو عبيد ابن قالت أبو عبيد ابن الجراح رضي الله عنهم ثم انتهت إلى هذا أو كما قالت رضي الله عنها أخرجه مسلم. عائشة رضي الله عنها, she said that when she was asked if the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم was to choose a leader after him, who would he choose? She said Abu Bakr. So she was asked then, who would he choose after Abu Bakr? So she said Umar ibn al-Khattab. So it was said then, who would be chosen after Umar? And she said Abu Ubaid ibn al-Jarrah radiallahu anhum. And then she stopped here, and this is collected authentically by Imam Muslim. And here we see the importance of placing Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhu in the forefront of this ummah after the last prophet and messenger to humanity sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There has been and continues to be, unfortunately, a discussion amongst the Muslims with who is the best of this ummah after the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But we see that during the time of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, from his statement and his actions, that they are Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhum. This is the belief of the people who came before us. Let's believe as they believe so that we can be successful. As Allah Ta'ala, He teaches us, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اهْتَدَوْا. And if they believe in what you believe in, then they would be guided. Meaning if they, those who come after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, they will believe in what you, meaning you, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, have believed in, then they, meaning those who come after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, would have been guided. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the belief of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba and the early generations of the Muslims who were upon the correct belief. بسم الله الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد, سفيان بن عيينة رحمه الله, he says, والحوض, or belief in the حوض, or the pool of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنه قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حوضي مسيرة شهر, ماؤه أبيض من اللبن, وريحه أطيب من المسك, وكيزانه كنجوم السماء, من شرب منها فلا يظمأ أبدا متفق عليه. عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما, he said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, my hold or my pool or the body of water that will be presented to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم ويوم القيامة, the distance is a month's journey. Meaning this is how great and magnificent the hold of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam is. It's more whiter than milk. Its fragrance is sweeter than musk. The number of its vessels is like the stars and the skies. And the sky, whoever drinks from it will never be thirsty again. This is collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. وعن سهل بن سعد رضي الله عنه قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنا فرضكم على الحوض من مر علي شرب ومن شرب لم يظمأ أبدا ليردن علي أقوام أعرفهم ويعرفوني ثم يحال بيني وبينهم فأقول إنهم مني فيقال إنك لا تدري ما أحدثوا بعدك فأقول سحقا سحقا لمن غير بعدي متفق عليه. سهل بن سعد رضي الله عنه, he said that the messenger of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, I will be before you at the hawd. Meaning the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be the first of this ummah to reach the hawd. He said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so whoever goes past me, then he will drink. He will drink of the hawd. And whoever drinks, then he will never ever be thirsty again. And then there will be some people who will go past, meaning without drinking from the hawd. So I will know them and they will know me. But then there will be a barrier or they will be separated from me. So I would say indeed they are from me, meaning from my ummah. But it will be said, you don't know what they invented in the religion after you. So he sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say, away with the one who changes the religion after me. Collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Here our belief in the hold of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it shows the contentment and the reward from amongst the rewards of paradise. And that is that if we're obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and upon the sunnah, then we will drink from the hold of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And whoever drinks from it will never be thirsty again. Meaning he will just enjoy contentment and satisfaction with his Lord, Tabarak wa Ta'ala. Also we see in here from amongst that which will prevent a Muslim from earning this magnificent reward is from changing the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or inventing in this religion that which is not from it. And whoever does this, he will be prevented from drinking from the hold of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when the Messenger alayhi wa sallam, knowing that those people are from his ummah, he will be concerned about them until he finds out that they have changed the religion after him by inventing in it that which is not from it, then he will say, away with them, away with them. And this shows the seriousness of the Muslims of entering bid'ah and the deen, because it will prevent you from drinking from the hold of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah, he says, was shafa'a, or the intercession. And Allah Ta'ala, he says, وَلَا يَمْلِكُ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ الشَّفَاعَةَ إِلَّا مَنْ شَهِدَ بِالْحَقِّ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. And those who call on other than him, meaning those who worship other than Allah, they have no power of possession of intercession except the one who bears witness to the truth and they know. Meaning they know that intercession is for Allah Ta'ala and that He will give it to whoever He chooses, from amongst his believing servants. And we also see in the hadith of Imran ibn Husayn radiallahu anhu, قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يخرج قوم من النار بشفاعة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فيدخلون الجنة أخرجه البخاري. عمران بن حسين رضي الله عنه, he said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that there will be some people who will exit from the fire by the intercession of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then they will enter Jannah. This is collected by Al-Bukhari. Here the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he teaches us that some Muslims will enter into the fire because of their disobedience to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or because of living a life of sin, that they will be entered into the fire and then they will be taken out of the fire by the intercession of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then they will be entered into Jannah. And this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's a warning to the Muslims to stay away from lifestyles of disobedience to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because you could be entered into the fire. And just as we're not able to handle the fire in this world by putting our hand over it for a second or a minute, then likewise be afraid of the fire that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for those who disbelieve and disobey Him and His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in this hadith is a warning for the Muslims to stay away from lifestyles of disobedience and sin. But it's also in this hadith glad tidings to the believers that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the last prophet and messenger to humanity, that whoever believes in him and follows his way, then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will intercede on their behalf on Yawm al-Qiyamah, and they will be taken out of the fire and put into Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst the people of Jannah. These are a few points of the beliefs of the Muslim based on Allah's book and the sunnah of His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as narrated to us by the Sahaba and the Tabi'un and the Tabi'in and the scholars of this deen. This is the belief of the Muslims. Hold on to your belief and teach your children your belief. Your belief, it affects your lifestyle. Your belief, it affects your character. Your belief affects the way that you'll be. If you're going to be a good, upright Muslim, then when it will stem from a good belief in Allah and what Allah has us to believe in. And if you're going to be a disobedient Muslim, then it will stem from your bad or improper belief in Allah and what Allah has us to believe in. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and help us to correct our belief and teach it to our children. Oh Allah, bless us to be upon the correct belief, that which is based on your book and the sunnah of your Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, bless us with lifestyles that are in accordance with belief in your book and the sunnah of your Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, save us from lifestyles of disobedience to you and your Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, save us from lifestyles of sin. Oh Allah, bless us with lifestyles of obedience to you and following the sunnah of your Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, bless us to be from the Muslims who give precedence to Abu Bakr and Umar. Oh Allah, bless us to be from amongst the Muslims who believe in the hold of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And oh Allah, bless us to drink from it on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Oh Allah, bless us to earn the intercession of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Oh Allah, bless us to believe in the Qadr. هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك, والحمد لله.